Sans Snow Dog cries for help, then is all smiles when this bus appears. But before we start, please take a moment to give this video a like, subscribe to Happy World, and hit the bell so you'll never miss these great stories. Like many places in the world, there's a homeless dog problem in Winnipeg, Canada. In the Great White North, however, homeless stray dogs face greater challenges with freezing cold temperatures and heavy snowfall. One snowed-out dog recently broke hearts on the internet when he emerged from the cold. Winnipeg is the coldest major Canadian city. In the winter, the average lows hover about 4 degrees Fahrenheit. The city is also known for its massive snowbanks that pile up after winter weather blankets the area. But the cold is what can truly make the outdoors a living hell in winter. And many of the region's stray dogs just have to deal with the cold. Canada's dog shelters are generally well-run and have a track record of increasing adoptions and decreasing euthanasia. But no matter how hard the shelters work to encourage adoption, Canada's remoteness makes it unlikely that they'll ever be able to fully address the problem of stray dogs. Some dogs live in the vast, cruel wild and cannot be collared. Stray dogs have become such a problem in Canada that organizations beyond the local shelters have become involved with plans to reduce their numbers humanely. The World Animal Protection Agency of Canada has been involved with the problem for 30 years, helping educate animal owners and helping municipalities address animal population control. And one of their biggest pushes is to encourage responsible dog ownership. One of the main aims of the group is to encourage responsible dog ownership because often the stray problem is caused by humans. By educating owners at the adoption sites and offering solutions for when owners can no longer provide a good home for the dog, the problem's reducing. One stray dog, however, resists any attempts to be picked up, but has found his daily slice of heaven. One stray dog was noticed in an area north of Winnipeg. He's often seen running through fields, his reddish fur making him pop out in the snow. Due to the cold and harsh environment, he's hungry, and people who have witnessed the dog say that he cries for attention. However, he resists when being approached and has evaded attempts at rescue. So one local group thought of another way to help. Feed the Fur Babies of Canada is a Winnipeg area nonprofit that operates as an alternative to a shelter. This organization runs collection drives for dog food, supplies, and money for vet services. Then its volunteers head out into the cold to deliver goodies to strays. And one of their volunteers spotted the lone reddish dog in the snow recently. One of the volunteers' full-time job is as a municipal bus driver. The driver, who asked to be anonymous, as she was likely doing something unauthorized on the job, added a new stop to her route so that her furry stray friend could get a daily meal. And the joy on the dog's face when the bus pulls up each day is magical. Still very skittish about being approached, a video posted on the group's Facebook page shows the dog happily dancing as the bus pulls up. Then the dog wags his tail and quickly makes off with the offered plastic bag of food. He can be seen darting back into the snow, explaining why attempts to rescue him have been difficult. Someday he might get to enjoy some warmth. It's hard to imagine why the dog would not crave the warmth that the bus driver and other volunteers have offered. Possibly he was hurt by a human and fears similar treatment. Or maybe the dog's just surviving fine and has found a remote warm spot to sleep. Hopefully, the dog will soon be enjoying the warmth, as the weather is not the only hazard up north. Not all stray dogs are cute and cuddly, unfortunately. The stray dog problem has created packs of feral dogs that are dangerous to pets and people. One woman in northern Manitoba was recently mauled to death by one of these packs. With organizations like Feed the Fur Babies of Canada and the WPA of Canada, hopefully stray numbers will continue to shrink for the good of the dogs and people.